Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Kristen Carosa. We continue to follow breaking news out of Manchester. These are pictures of an active investigation after reports of shots fired near 263 Manchester Street. This investigation is impacting three nearby schools, which are either locked down or in secure campus mode. Police are searching for two suspects, one with tan or khaki shorts and a white shirt, one dressed in all black. We will bring you more information as soon as we learn it. A Nashua man facing charges in connection with an overdose death waived his right to a hearing. The Attorney General's office says Kevin Manchester sold fentanyl to a young mother who overdosed and died. WMUR's Ray Brewer spoke with the suspect's mother and has the story.
This is an old booking photo of 27-year-old Kevin Manchester, the Nashua man waiving his arraignment Thursday morning at Superior Court in Nashua.
At this point, Kevin Manchester has been indicted on a number of different charges, and one of those includes a sale of a drug, in this case specifically fentanyl, and that caused a death.
The AG's office alleges that the fentanyl sold by Manchester in January resulted in the death of Michelle McLeod. If convicted, Manchester could be sentenced to life in prison.
I don't have any words. He doesn't deserve that.
Julianne Manchester showed up at the courthouse to support her son. His tale, she says, is one that is all too familiar. She says Kevin got addicted to painkillers that were prescribed for him as he was playing high school sports.
With bangs and bruises and concussions, the doctors gave him pain medication so he could continue to play.
Manchester says they sent their son to rehab, and for 3 years he was clean, only to slip back into his addiction. As for Kevin's alleged victim, Michelle McLeod,
and I'm very, very sorry for her. I'm very sorry for her children and her family. I mean, my heart breaks for them.
But Manchester says her son would never intentionally sell anything to hurt anyone, that he was only selling to support his habit, and that a long prison sentence for her son won't solve anything.
He's an addict. He has a disease, he's sick, and I will put him back in rehab. That's what a lot of these people need. They don't need jail time, they need rehab.
That was Ray Brewer reporting. A deadly wrong-way crash leads to a DUI charge against a Vermont man. The near head-on crash happened near exit 20 just before 9 last night. Troopers say 38-year-old Daniel Cowdery was driving on the wrong side of the highway when he collided with a car driven by 34-year-old Ellen Kolish. Kolish died at the scene. A 4-year-old in her car was also seriously injured. Crews in Auburn are preparing four utility poles. Police say a dump truck took down the utility poles last night on Chester Road near Wilson's Crossing Road. The area is closed while crews make repairs. Detours are in place, but police are asking drivers to avoid the area. Calling hours begin this afternoon for a Massachusetts police officer killed in the line of duty. Auburn police officer Ron Tarantino was shot and killed during a traffic stop on Sunday. The gunman later died in a shootout with police. Calling hours are from 2 to 7 today at St. Joseph's Church in Charlton, Massachusetts. His funeral will be held tomorrow. To commitment 2016 now, Donald Trump is weighing in on behalf of New Hampshire's first in the nation primary after new threats to its leadoff status in 2020 emerge. In a statement to WMUR, Trump national campaign manager Corey Lewandowski, a resident of Windham, said, "If Mr. Trump is president, the New Hampshire primary won't be moving." The statement comes as establishment forces on the Republican National Committee are proposing ending or diluting the state's first in the nation status. Read more from John DeStaso on the latest threat to the primary and his New Hampshire primary source column. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.